In this video, we're going to have a look at how you can navigate around the other modules in Lightroom, which is Map, Book, Slideshow, Print, and Web. All of those modules can be accessed from the top right-hand side of your screen. So we're going to start in Library again, and let's have a look at how you can work through the program. As with Library and Develop, each module has the tabs on the side, and then you can also add the thumbnail views at the bottom. So let's start with Map. By clicking at the top right-hand corner, you'll see we get to a Google Maps page right inside Lightroom. Now what you can do here is you can geotag your images and you can put them wherever in the world you took those images, you can add them there, which gives you like a visual journey of what you of where you've traveled and the images you've taken. As with Google Maps, at the bottom of the screen, Map Style, you can change to Roadmap, which will then give you, if you zoom in, all your exact roads, so you can be very specific. Satellite and Hybrid, those are all your general Google Maps features. Navigator at the top left here works exactly the same as in your Library and Develop modules. So if you drag around the map, you will again, you can use the Navigator to see where exactly you are. One below that, Save Locations. Here you can add your different locations, for example, Kenya, Masai Mara, Amboseli, Chobe, whatever the case is. And then once again, Collections is always there. So you can always see which group of images you are working with. On a side note, Collections is the only panel that is present throughout all the different modules. On the other side here, pretty simple, just the metadata for your specific images. Now, I have not selected any images for here, so it says no photos selected. If I wanted to, I will go down here, select an image, and it gives me all the details, exactly the same as in the Library module. Next one, if we go up to the top, you click on Book. What you see now is the page which you can create a coffee table book right inside Lightroom. Now, the program that's built in here will take you to a website called Blurb, where you can create your own coffee table book, print it out, and they will post it right to you. Very easy. On the top left hand, let's start there, preview. Again, as you work through your book, you can see the pages here, and it works the same as the Navigator as you work through the program. Again, Collections, same thing. There's the images you are working with. On the other side now, on the right-hand side, this is pretty monkey see, monkey do type stuff, where if you just go right from the top of the panels on the right-hand side, open them one by one, you can just work down these various menus, book, the size, the cover. So you just use the drop-down menus to select all your options. It'll give you an estimated price for your book. You keep on going down. Auto layout, you can allow Lightroom to do the layout for you. Pages, guides, cells. So you basically just go from the top to bottom here, set all the settings and import your images into your book. Nice one to play with, and the quality is phenomenal as well. Next one up, you've got Slideshow. This here is, if you want to create a slideshow for friends and family, you can import a whole bunch of images, create the slideshow, and then save it and play it out on a TV, on a screen, or even on the internet. On the top left-hand panel, let's start there again, you have Preview, which will show you, once you've got a whole bunch of images in there, it'll give you a preview of your slideshow. It comes with a whole bunch of template, already designed templates for you. Caption and rating, crop to full. So as you click on those, it's got all the different settings that you can play with once your slideshow is up and running. Now again, as with slideshow, print, web, and book all work the same. You basically go to the right-hand tab on the page, start from the top, and just work your way down. Stroke, border, cast shadow. So you can just work down each of these, do your settings, set all the borders, and then when you finish, right at the bottom, you just hit play or preview, and you can then save that slideshow as a final product. Moving on to print, again, same layout, you'll see the repetition starts coming in here. Preview will show you what you are printing, right? Your specific layout. If we add a few images to this, let's do that, you can see the print layout will automatically add them for you. Keeping that for now, moving over to the right-hand side, layout style, single image contact sheet, picture package. You've got all these settings on the side to play with, zoom to fill, rotate to fit, and you can keep on playing with these until you see what you want to print. It's easy. You just look at the page in the middle and you can see what the final answer is going to be. How many rows, how many columns. So like I said, start from the top and work your way down, simple as that. And then the last one, web. What this does is you can select a whole bunch of images here, and what Lightroom will do for you is create a web gallery. Simple as that. So this, what you see in the middle, is a live preview of what your website, your web gallery will look like. Click on the image, it'll take you back. So this also comes, if you look at the top left-hand side, with a whole bunch, there's your preview of different templates that you can use. So as you click it, there's a live preview in the middle of the screen of what your final web gallery will look like. Again, to make the settings, you start on the right-hand side from the top, work your way down, and then either export it to a file or you upload it straight to the web. Simple as that. So, map, book, slideshow, print, and web, easy to navigate through. Your preview's in the middle, you start on the right-hand side from the top and work your way down. Simple as that. In this video, we're going to have a look at how you can navigate around the other modules in Lightroom, which is Map, Book, Slideshow, Print, and Web. All of those modules can be accessed from the top right-hand side of your screen. So we're going to start in Library again, and let's have a look at how you can work through the program. As with Library and Develop, each module has the tabs on the side, and then you can also add the thumbnail views at the bottom. So let's start with Map. By clicking at the top right-hand corner, you'll see we get to a Google Maps page right inside Lightroom. Now what you can do here is you can geotag your images and you can put them wherever in the world you took those images, you can add them there, which gives you like a visual journey of what you of where you've traveled and the images you've taken. As with Google Maps, at the bottom of the screen, map style, you can change to roadmap, which will then give you, if you zoom in, all your exact roads so you can be very specific. Satellite and hybrid, those are all your general Google Maps features. Navigator at the top left here works exactly the same as in your Library and Develop modules. So if you drag around the map, you will again, you can use the navigator to see where exactly you are. One below that, save locations. Here you can add your different locations, for example, Kenya, Masai Mara, Amboseli, Chobe, whatever the case is. And then once again, collections is always there. So you can always see which group of images you are working with. On a side note, collections is the only panel that is present throughout all the different modules. On the other side here, pretty simple, just the metadata for your specific images. Now I have not selected any images for here, so it says no photo selected. If I wanted to, I will go down here, select an image, and it gives me all the details, exactly the same as in the Library module. Next one, if we go up to the top, you click on Book. What you see now is the page which you can create a coffee table book right inside Lightroom. Now, the program that's built in here will take you to a website called Blurb, where you can create your own coffee table book, print it out, and they will post it right to you, very easy. On the top left hand, let's start there, preview, again, as you work through your book, you can see the pages here, and it works the same as the navigator as you work through the program. Again, collections, same thing, there's the images you are working with. On the other side now, on the right hand side, this is pretty monkey see, monkey do type stuff, where if you just go right from the top of the panels on the right hand side, open them one by one, you can just work down these various menus, book, the size, the cover. So you just use the drop down menus to select all your options. It'll give you an estimated price for your book. You keep on going down. Auto layout, you can allow Lightroom to do the layout for you. Pages, guides, cells. So you basically just go from the top to bottom here, set all the settings and import your images into your book. Nice one to play with, and the quality is phenomenal as well. Next one up, you've got slideshow. This here is, if you want to create a slideshow for friends and family, you can import a whole bunch of images, create the slideshow, and then save it and play it out on a TV, on a screen, or even on the internet. On the top left-hand panels, let's start there again, you have preview, which will show you, once you've got a whole bunch of images in there, it'll give you a preview of your slideshow. It comes with a whole bunch of template, already designed templates for you. Caption, rating, crop to fill. So as you click on those, it's got all the different settings that you can play with once your slideshow is up and running. Now again, as with slideshow, print, web, and book all work the same. You basically go to the right-hand tab of the page, start from the top, and just work your way down. Stroke, border, cast shadow. So you can just work down each of these, do your settings, set all the borders, and then when you finish, right at the bottom, you just hit play or preview, and you can then save that slideshow as a final product. Moving on to print, again, same layout, you'll see the repetition starts coming in here. Preview will show you what you are printing, right? Your specific layout. If we add a few images to this, let's do that, you can see the print layout will automatically add them for you. Keeping that for now, moving over to the right-hand side, layout style, single image contact sheet, picture package. You've got all these settings on the side to play with, zoom to fill, rotate to fit, and you can keep on playing with these until you see what you want to print. It's easy. You just look at the page in the middle and you can see what the final answer is going to be. How many rows, how many columns. Like I said, start from the top and work your way down. Simple as that. And then the last one, web. What this does is you can select a whole bunch of images here, and what Lightroom will do for you is create a web gallery. Simple as that. So this, what you see in the middle, is a live preview of what your website, your web gallery will look like. Click on the image, it'll take you back. So this also comes, if you look at the top left-hand side, with a whole bunch, there's your preview of different templates that you can use. So as you click it, there's a live preview in the middle of the screen of what your final web gallery will look like. Again, to make the settings, you start on the right hand side from the top, work your way down, and then either export it to a file or you upload it straight to the web. Simple as that. So, map, book, slideshow, print, and web, easy to navigate through. Your preview's in the middle, you start on the right hand side from the top and work your way down. Simple as that.